In today's climate, the small business owner, the entrepreneur, is in big trouble. In fact, he's missing out on the technologies and the resources, the education, all the information that is needed for them to take their business to the next level and tap into the globalized economy.
I don't think there's anybody that has not been hit by this economic slump. And if you take your average small business owner, it's been extremely difficult.
They're lacking the communication skills, the distribution, the marketing to make this happen for them.
And they're looking for something. They're really looking for a solution. What can they do to come together and pull out of this?
Well, we all know that there's countless institutions that already pre-exist, like the Chamber of Commerce, the BNIs, and the TIPS, and the Kiwanis and Lions. But at the end of the day, they don't have the solution or the infrastructure to connect.
The problem is that there's no structure that unites the different entities. So they're all kind of like on an island on their own, and there's nothing that kind of makes it this whole. So they don't actually benefit off of one another.
Because the entrepreneur is lacking in so many areas, from the education, the resources, the connections, how to go global, they're afraid to take it to the next level. The U.S. government has primarily focused on the large corporations, giving them stimulus packages, encouraging the big corporations rather than looking at the very pillar of this great nation, the grassroots, the entrepreneur.
You know, the government tried and didn't succeed. You know, with all these stimulus packages and the money, it didn't trickle down and benefit the small business owner. I mean, they're slowly being squeezed out more and more and more.
So in order to make this happen, we're gonna have to lock arms in order to get around the bureaucracy and the government to make a difference in this nation and the economy.
We have to empower members of the community. We're really just the hub that creates the platform that the members of the community are gonna use.
We're providing the connections, the leads, the customers, the business etiquette for those who need manufacturing and distribution or services, whether it's local, national, or global. We've accomplished this through a blend of technology and face-to-face interaction in a way that's never been done before.
Let's take the power of those face-to-faces, of the relationships that are built there, but those have got to be leveraged and enhanced by technology, because to ignore technology means that you are not growing to your full potential or taking advantage of what's out there. So we kind of took a look at it and said, look, what can we do to take the best of what's going on like Facebook and Twitter and whatnot, and definitely the power of social media, and bring these things together to create something that has never been done before?
And then we blended the face-to-face meetings and mixers with the high-tech tools like social media, software, mobile apps.
We knew with what we were trying to accomplish here and all the organization that needed to happen, we knew that we were going to have to rely on technology, on software and applications, because it truly is very grand in scale on what we're trying to do as far as standardizing these local mixers and the way that business owners can connect both online and offline. And that's really important to distinguish that we're not just an online company, we're not just an offline company, we truly are bridging both. So, you know, we have a lot of ground to cover here.
There are so many moving pieces and parts that technology is required to organize something of this magnitude.
There are chapters, and then those chapters tie into the mainframe system. So nationwide, worldwide, they actually gain recognition. And that's really what Successful Thinkers is doing. We're creating the platform that's going to be driven by the community, but it's great because we can use technology to help control and guide that structure, and then of course educate everybody how to actually use it. And that's such an important aspect of it.
We place a very high value on education. In fact, our research has shown that most business owners are lacking the very basics of business fundamentals. Successful Thinkers Network is not only going to teach them how to use the system and how to upload their picture and fill out their bio and proper business etiquette, but also how to succeed in their own business.
And we realize that we've got a duplicatable system now that somebody can easily step into and run and follow the rules and guidelines, and then just everybody benefits. Everybody can concentrate on building their business. They don't have to worry about doing all the organization that's been done for them.
One of the main benefits is that the business owner can sell himself along with his product or service, and that gives him an edge up over the competition. A lot of business owners are led to believe that they can just do business online or in general with anybody without building trust. We already know what that's led to: empty promises and empty pockets.
You know, the face-to-face concept, which cannot be beat. You cannot replace face-to-face. That is so important, and nothing will ever replace it.
With Successful Thinkers Network, the members of each of the local communities are patrolling their own chapters. And if there's anyone that's not practicing good business habits, well, they're going to be discovered. Above all, it's about creating the relationships. We've created a structured environment for people to do business with people they can trust. For nearly 30 years, I've developed several training companies that have all had to do with education, current tools of the times, and building relationships that have empowered the business owner.
When I first met Jim, it was really exciting because, again, you know, Jim likes to go out and obviously he's the front guy. He goes out there and markets and works with the individuals in the field. And it was just awesome. I mean, it was awesome to see him work. I mean, I saw him build. I mean, personally, we ran training companies together. And I've seen him build businesses that have had hundreds of thousands of people in the following. And it's fantastic to see him up there on stage. He's got great stage presence. As far as a motivational speaker, people really listen and respond to what he says. So
everything I've done has prepared me for Successful Thinkers Network, teaching me the value of relationships and how strong of a role it plays in business.
And he and I kind of get in this think tank mode and we're kind of pulling these ideas out of the air and figuring out, you know, how can we make them work? How can we apply these, you know, the technology that's out there and the ideas of what the field needs and come up with a good solution? So it's been a really, really good relationship.
Steve can take a concept and make it a reality because he understands human nature. At the same time, he can work with the IT department, the designers, the video production crew, the marketing department. I mean, he's the guy that makes everything connect.
I've run a couple web design companies, and having also run a training company, it's been great to, you know, see what works out there in the field and then to apply that knowledge in a creative way with the teams. And, you know, how can we package this? How can we make it so, you know, boil it down to the common denominator where anybody can understand it and duplicate it and get it out there? The model works. I mean, that's not even a question. I mean, we've spent enough time out there seeing the response to what we're doing.
I've seen the emotion. I've seen the excitement. I've seen the changes. I've seen the success. I know firsthand that people want this. They need it. It's right. They walk up to me and tell me the same thing. Jim, this thing has changed my life. It's affected my business in a positive way. It's the best thing that's ever happened. I want to share this with the world. It's been an honor. It's been humbling. It's been exciting to know that we've embarked on the right journey, to know that we're actually leaving a legacy as we go forward with this thing. And I'm just proud and excited to know that, you know, I've had a hand in helping change the way people think, change the economy, and know that together, we're going to make a positive impact on this world in a time that we need it.